One by one, they boarded the jumbo jet, the first leg of their mission that will lead to Afghanistan. The Vermont Guard has been preparing for this for months, and so have their families.
I am proud.
11-year-old Wyatt Glodgett stayed close to his dad, Forrest, who is a command sergeant from Jericho.
The soldiers that we have in this Vermont brigade and, you know, from the other states that are going with us are so talented that it's awesome for me.
But his wife, Kara, was a bundle of nerves.
We're hoping it's just, you know, it's 12 months and we'll just have to go with it. Do the best we can, just like he's going to do.
The national anthem echoed inside the giant military hangar. A stream of dignitaries thanked soldiers for their service.
The mission that you are undertaking is of extraordinary importance.
In the harsh deserts of Afghanistan.
They will join fellow troops from across New England for duty training Afghan national police and security. They will try somehow to stabilize a dangerous place.
You are the very finest our state and nation have to offer.
In a conflict now entering its ninth year, many of these soldiers have been deployed before, but not all.
Is this your first time?
It is my first time, yes.
The send-off for Gary Markries of Grand Isle included his wife and three children and parents.
We've had a long time to prepare, and it helps you put things in order.
All said they're confident and very proud. And at the same time,
my nerves are churning inside. It's a scary thing.
Soldiers now begin final training in Louisiana and Indiana. With a short break for the holidays, they should arrive in Afghanistan in January.
Tonight, about 900 Vermont soldiers have now left the state. The remaining 600 or so will leave in three chartered jumbo jet flights here, beginning about 9 tomorrow morning. We're live at the airport in South Burlington tonight. Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5. Kelly?